Good day, everybody. Chris Effie here. Now, what have I got for you? This lovely little delight here. There's a thing which has been around, I think, a little bit, but it's the future. And if you weren't a conspiratorial type of person, and you were sort of teetering on the edge of all this control, then I would say that this might just push you over, because people, the timing is perfect. Once we've been scurrying away in our little hidey holes and being protected by the powers that be, they've been busy as bees, as you can imagine, what with the 5G and all the interconnecting roads and the infrastructure basically all getting better for us. And look what we have here. Look, what 3 words. Interesting, right? Now, you're not going to believe this, believe me, but this is true. This is happening. Now, could you imagine everyone in the world having a mobile phone, and they're actually, they have a mobile phone, and or whatever it is, they're pretty, I don't know. But have a look at this. This is amazing. This really is. Now, what is it? What 3 words? Now, basically, what they've done is they've divided up the whole wide world, the sea, the land, into 3 meters by 3 meter squares. And each square, I'm going to show it, each square has a unique ID of 3 words. And as you can see here, it's got this square, whatever they're pointing to, is called clever.bridge.couches. And that's in Queensland, Australia. Yes, it's the simplest way to talk about a location. So I'm at Clever Bridge Couches, people. And you'd probably be able to type that in, wing straight to it. So if you're on a mobile phone, or you have something like an implant or something, whatever, pin here, you know, where's so-and-so? Ah, he's there. Anywhere in the world. And you could be bobbing along happily in a little boat in the middle of the Pacific Ocean. And bang, they know exactly where you are. And maybe all the satellites which are going around, maybe something to do with Starlink. I don't know. I'm just putting that out there. But, you know, timing is everything, isn't it? So let's get into this a little bit more, shall we? Because this is really exciting. And science too. Right, so that's all we've got. What is 3 words? We've divided the world into 3 meter squares and gave each square a unique combination of 3 words. It's the easiest way to find and share exact locations. Oh, isn't that Uber? No reference there to the company, I'm sure. But here we go. You can download the free app. It's free, people. You can download it. It's used already by millions. Millions of people around the world use what-3-words to make life safer. It's safer for you because you know which square you're in. Yes, back to square one. There can't be a square one because it has to be... I wonder if there's a square called 111. I don't know. I don't care. You can actually... it's more efficient and less frustrating for them, perhaps, than us. Ways to use it. I'll click on that in a minute. Let's just go through the intro screen first. Helping businesses worldwide. Thousands of businesses use what-3-words to improve efficiencies and customer experience. I need to buy something. I'm in square so-and-so. Wherever you're in square so-and-so. That's 3,000 squares away. That's going on, you know. How can it help? How can it benefit? How can it benefit a company? Because they need to deliver it to you, so the van can go to this square. I mean, as if GPS position points aren't accurate enough. No, they've confined us into these 3 meter squares now. The only problem being, though, is if you live at the top of a block of flats, all these people are going to be in the same square, because I'm sure it takes up the airspace too, perhaps. So, thousands of businesses use what-3-words to improve efficiencies, customer experience, from e-commerce and logistics companies to travel, ride hailing. Oh, there we go again. Yeah, I mentioned that U word, didn't I? Yeah. And navigation apps. Improve my business with what-3-words. I don't know, future facing. We're providing the location, precision, and simplicity needed by drones. There you go. Voice controlled devices and driverless cars. Oh my word, you could be targeted at an instant, could you? Really? So once they got your face, then see me in the square. Bye bye. What else we got there? Unit pillow culling. Oh no, that's just the name of the square that that fireman's in. Look,
there's a fire in unit pillow culling. Quick, get there. It's in Bedfordshire.
I know where it is. I can see it on the map. I've got the square highlighted now. Supporting life-saving services. Around the world, emergency services and NGOs. NGOs. I don't know. Non-something organisation? Non-giving? I don't know. Are using what three words to find and help people in need. View case studies. I'll get into that. I've got to show you stuff here first. What people are saying. The BBC News. The app can save your life.
Damn square, help save me.
A fiendishly clever solution by the Times. The Philadelphia Inquirer. Move aside Google Maps. The future of navigation is just three words. One of the cleverest technologies I have seen. Financial Times. The Economist. Ingenious. It is. It ticks all boxes, doesn't it? No pun intended. But yes, it ticks all boxes. Anyway, I did find something here. Oh, look at this. Oh, yes, the sponsors. Who's it sponsored by? Backed by Mercedes-Benz, RMX, Intel. Okay. Sake Motor Company, Subaru, Channel 4 even. Sony, DB, whatever that is. David Banner? Oh, David Banner is all that way. Horizon Ventures, Alpine, Mobile Media. Oh, look, there's some more down here. Look, I can choose them. Yes, Lonely Planet, Schenker. Oh, DB Schenker. Dave Banner's Schenker, don't know. Mercedes-Benz again, Ford, Cabify for the ride, Premier Inn, Transport for London. That's the tube, is it? Or Transport for London? Because they don't know where they are at any given time, do they? No, so these squares, I wonder if the squares actually match underground as well. Aramax, who else? Network Rail, of course, they need to know where their squares are going through, don't they? Network Rail, yes. Random Nautica. Oh, look, it's got a bent owl on it. UK Power Networks, AOCOM, Avenza. I'm not advertising, I'm saying who. Honest Burgers. I don't know, how would you know if a burger's honest or not? Depends what's in it, right? Okay, and these are the awards, Fires Company, Right, okay, so we've got down to that, so why is it better than a traditional address? Now, what I want to do is I want to get to the meat of it now. I want to get to the meat. I've got to go to the meat of it. And what I want to do is, oh my word, I had it up here just a minute ago. Where has it gone? Did I need to go home? I'm at home, aren't I? Map, here we go, map. Right, yes, here we are. Now this has just come up, now look at this, everybody. These are all the squares. Now I can click on a square here. And it tells me Cliff Ready Youth. So this is a square. Now, I wonder how. Oh look, down here is like just a little bit related to Google Earth. This look, because I can bring up where it actually is. Looks rather nice, doesn't it? Now, I'm not sure if you'd be able to see it, but you can actually see these pictures have been overlaid with all of these squares. And this is 3 meters by 3 meters. Look, and a great pure model. Share, navigate, save. So you could save a square. Yes, you could save a square and go back to it later on and then seek it out. But, I mean, joking aside, look. So as I pan out, the squares, you know, you have to fill the screen. All of these squares are 3 meters by 3 meters. So, this is the UK somewhere, I'm sure. Let me just zoom out. Please bear with me. Look, and I can click anywhere. It gives me, I can click anywhere without even looking. I'm going to a square. Look. So, let's go to somewhere. Let's go to my workplace, shall we? That's in Plymouth. Yes, let's go to Plymouth. And I can check out that's Swindon. Oh, hang on, perhaps if I zoom out a bit more, it won't be so painful for you watching. Right, so I'm just going to start with the basics first. So let's go to Plymouth. Here we are. Now, While I'm here, let's see. I know. No, I won't do that. I was going to go to the Edgestone Rock. I'll go here in a minute. But it's Roborough. Yes. And it's here. Okay. So I used it. My office is roughly about. Do I really want to say that on here?
I could be targeted.
Perhaps not. It is a silly thought. Right, now, so I've just picked up. But let's go to the middle of Dartmoor then. Let's go to... I mean, this is really interesting. Let's go to the middle of Dartmoor, where you would not necessarily tread with a tour. It's quite barren here. Look, this really is. There's a lot of dead land here, you know, and you go hiking and... Up here, so look, let's go. Oh, look, it's got a square mural, awesome billiard. Yes, I wonder. I mean, it must have been actually thinking out how can I put these words in, unless they were randomly generated, and they're all in English too. I'm sure it's translated into different languages throughout the world. Now, if I zoom in onto this one, and it's as you can see, pretty nothing much there. It looks actually. It could be Mars, couldn't it? Look, it's very dry and barren. Well, let's get rid of that right in there. Oh, God, there's some more right in there. Hang on, bring that there, bring that down. No, bring that one up. Oh, no, go in a bit. There we go. Looks like Mars, doesn't it? Yeah, so as I'm going off the beaten track here, literally. Okay, so you can see here, look, it's all squares, look. It's all squares. I can't zoom anymore. I'm not sure if you'd be able to see... The squares here, but they are here. So, and as you see this moving around, I'm moving the squares. I can highlight that one around. I can do this one. So that's in the middle of Dartmoor. Okay, let's zoom out. Middle of Dartmoor. Now, so let's go to. Well, let's go to Isle of Lundy there. That's the Isle of Lundy, isn't it? Oh, yes. They've done that one as well. Jump garlic gained. Yeah, it's very... oh, look. I'm in the middle of the English Channel. Let's go to... let's go... See if I can find Eddystone here, shall we? Oh, look. Sorry. We have no imagery here. Okay, let's go to here then.
It's Plymouth Despair.
Am I rambling yet? Can't see the Eddystone anyway. It's usually about... Oh, no... It says Google on it, though. So they're in cahoots with Google here. Yes, they are. Sorry, no image there. These are the sailing routes for the Plymouth Ferry. And if you'd watched UK Columns today, you'd have seen one leave. So they must be over here somewhere, doing a little shooting somewhere over here, doing their little videos for UK Column. Yeah, shout out UK Column. Very good stuff too. Anyway, I'm defeating the object and I'm wasting time. Right, so I'm rambling. So it's in the middle of the sea. You can click anywhere in this you want and you'll get a coordinate. Look, I'm in the middle of the Atlantic here. Balancing overhanging in Kemp's related. That's off the Irish coast there, look. Right, so now. So don't forget, people, this whole world. Let's go to Outer Mongolia. Yes, tis a nice place. That's China. So Mongolia's going to be up here somewhere. I'm sure it is. Yes, there's Russia. So Mongolia's there. There we are. So look at that. Incidentally, all Mongolians that are born are entitled to claim 1 kilometre square of land. Anywhere of their choosing within the Mongolian borders. They are. So you just go anywhere inside this area here and say... Boom, that's where I'm living. Ulaanbaatar. That's the capital of Mongolia. I've been there. That's a rather up-and-coming place back in the day. Let's have a look. And the Kyrgyz Lake. That is probably the best water that's around. Anyway. So, you wouldn't typically think, I'm going to go here today. Look. Is the square. Now it's changed map because there's no actual data for that. So it's so if I zoom in down here, which you saw, well, there's a road nearby. Let's come over to here then. Smack bang in the middle of these roads. Who would want to go there? I don't know. But look, you can come into here, and as I zoom down, I zoom further down. Come on. Where are you? I can't see the grid yet. It's got to be 3 meters. Maybe it needs a little bit of updating. Prosecutes causeway flag. What's on the next one to it then? Outbound roundly profusely. Sounds like something I know. Safari ultimatum occasion. Oh, come on. Where's the grid? Come on. There it is. Can you see it? This is the grid, people. Here. Look. All these squares. You must be able to see them now, surely. Look. All these squares are the world over. Every square, every single point on the map has an identical, identified 3D square. 3 meters by 3 meters, and you could work out how many people you could get in there, really. So once you have say one person in there, you could track a person going from there into them, you know, you could have a game of chess with this, couldn't you, really? You could line people up, and you know, it's like a pawn takes a knight eight or something, and then boof, you go bang. And eradicate them. Just a bit of fun. But there you go. Right, so that's in the middle of Mongolia. It's all been identified. Now, one thing I must do as well is have a look at, see who runs, who owns. It's got to be the big boys, hasn't it? Now, I'm right in the middle of the Pacific. Let's go to the North Pacific. Let's go to the middle of, I mean, if I was here, I'd be in trouble, wouldn't I? So let's go to
here.
No, it's come a bit further south. Yeah, I don't really want to go towards Tonga, but let's go to here. That's pretty much in furthest away from anything I can be. And there you are. It has its square. Yes. And it's definitely, it's probably saying no data, but I'm just carry on. Come back. Come back here. Yeah. Come on. Now, I'll just let that, see if I can let that update a minute. Let's have a look. Yes, there's all the squares. Yes, can you see the squares again? Bum, 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 bum. Turning invokes dress. Imagine you could actually, wouldn't it be something if you could remember every square's name and exactly where it is, you know? Every square invokes commandeering denying. Bookmarked commandeering denying. Bookmark, oh, was that two? Was that one there? Chauffeured naive locus. I mean, they're quite Armada week night hitchhiked. Not bad. We're going to say navigate. Let's click on the navigate. So City Mapper, Google Maps, Bing Maps, Waze. I don't know what Waze is. But there you go. So in the middle of the sea. Now you might be thinking you can have a play with this. What's the website called? Yes. what-3-words.com subjectivism playbooks dockside. Don't know. Anyway. Be afraid, people. Be very, very afraid. So when your phone, does your phone need the app for this? I mean, they'd be able to say what square you're in.
It's now transcending from subjectivism playbook dark side and has just moved to prosperous, weep, poignant Mr. Jackson.
Okay, so let's go up to the oh look, there's a, it's funny this, isn't it? Because there's nothing here, yet I can put a square there. They've got a square, an identified square. Yes. Above this line here. And incidentally, the line that we're talking about, if I click open this fellow here, and I shall drag him across. Now, look at this fellow here, right? This is that map thingy. Yeah, and if you care to see, I might have the 24 hours I've got this set to, you might see the probably, it's probably not now because it's probably longer than 24 hours. No, it's 18:45 yesterday. No, I probably won't start. But you could see a shadow up here. I've got a quarter shadow there when the eclipse, eclipse was going on. And just like that. But anyway, as you can see, they don't go anywhere above this type of, just above, which is, I think, Whales in Alaska's there, little Whales Ailes Airport. So with that, I should take that away and get back to here. Let's come. Now I can't, it won't let me scroll back out again. I can't scroll out. Can I now? Perhaps if I come down here. I don't know why it's not letting me do anything here. It's not letting me, it's not letting me scroll out again. Why is it not letting me go smaller? Oops, I think there's a fault with this site. Let's do an F5. It's gone. Right. I don't know where I am now. Can I scroll out? Yes, I can. Yeah, I just think it was a bit of a little site glitch there. Let it load. Come out, wherever you are. Right, and it's not letting me go any higher than there, but on the other map it was a bit lower. So they've done their job. Yes, anywhere you care to look, there's a square. Even in the Bering Strait, look. What does it prove? I don't know. Who's going to benefit from this? I mean, it's not as if we can't get around as it is, and if we travel any great distances, we're usually taken there by a predetermined courier of travel agents of sorts, right? So, just thought I'd put that out there. Now, if I go back to the... If I go back to whom? About us, is there anything in there? Developer, let's go to the developer site. API... UX guidelines. Who are these people? Design, communicate, get back again. Can't see that. I have to move the camera. Our story. All right, let's go for our story then. Hello. Yeah, come on. Let's see what it says. Our story. Chris Sheldrick used to work in the music industry, organising events around the world. He quickly discovered that in the music world, people struggle with poor dressing every day. Getting lost trying to find events was pretty common. That's probably because you're pretty stoned out of your head. He had some pretty bad days, like in Italy, when a driver unloaded all the equipment an hour north of Rome instead of an hour south of Rome, and a slightly worse day when a keyboard player called him and said, "Chris, don't panic, but we may have just sound-checked at the wrong wedding." Well, I mean, it just takes a bit more organising, doesn't it? And planning ahead. You know, that's what I would say to you. But no, we have this worldwide system now, which solves all my incapabilities of being able to organise something properly, especially as I make my living from it. Go and tell the Marines, for God's sake. Anyway, excuse me, I know plans mean birds, but I mean, this is our story. So read more, dare I? After experiencing several similarly frustrating situations, oh God, he realised that addressing around the world just wasn't good enough. To get people and equipment to the right places on time, he tried sharing GPS coordinates instead, but asking people to meet at the likes of 40.712777 was just too unreliable. What, because they had the exact coordinates? Why can't you just put a pin in a map and then send that to them, as you can in Google Maps? Honestly, it's not that hard to even think about it. Entering 60 numbers in, no, you don't, you just send them the pin. After experiencing a few too many navigation nightmares, Chris sat with his mathematician school friend, Mohan Gainsalingham, to find a way to describe a location that would be best precise to GPS coordinates, but more concise and easy to find for people to use. Before long, Mohan created the first 3-word address algorithm on the back of an envelope. Oh, doesn't that story sound familiar? Chris and Mohan then connected with Jack Whaley Cohen, also a school friend, with a background in translation, and what-3-words was born. It's been 5 years since Chris Moran and Jack co-founded 3-words. Today, millions of people across the world are using 3-word address to find, share, describe places faster and more easily, from festival goers, travellers, to delivery drivers, event organisers and postal services. This is the first I've heard of it this week. You would think this would be all over the place, wouldn't it? I mean, I'm sure people have heard about this, but that's three people. And on the back of an envelope, oh, give me a break, you know? Give me a break. You're probably, I mean, all these, you go to Mercedes with this idea, oh, yeah, here, here's £1 million. Somebody says, oh, yeah, here's £1 million. That's going to make my business grow, isn't it? Tosses. Sorry. So there we are. What else is there? Let's go back to the map, shall we? Let's go back to the map. Oh, back to Magdalen Bridge. I don't know where that is. I wonder what is that Magdalen Bridge? It must be something important because this is where it defaults to all the time. It is probably his mother's house or something. No, I don't know. It's got to be something Masonic about it. I don't know. I don't know what this is. What is that? Oh, it's a college. Maybe that's where he went to college. Maybe this is where they drew on an envelope. Yes, sitting on a table in the middle of this. We shall. What are these called? Churn Rips Vine. So I think that what was the first one? Let's go. Let's do a refresh on that and see where it defaults to. No. Okay. Where was it? It was on that bridge, wasn't it? It was here somewhere, wasn't it? Yes. No, somewhere along here, wasn't it? Yeah, Magdalen Bridge. Anyway. So you've all got a square, people. Wherever you're situated, on terra firma, or whether on water, or even in the air, really. I suppose they could actually, it extends right up into the airspace, doesn't it? Because then you'd be able to see where each square you are passing. I'm not sure if you can actually see the squares here. It's like, you know. But it's all to do with Google Earth. But yet they probably had this all planned in a way prior. But then just making it as though these three people have come up with this idea and concept. Yeah, with an algorithm. Okay. How hard is it to break all the world up into the tiny little squares? But then you need to embed each one of these as an app into a program so you can actually, you know. Then connect with Google Earth. It's just another extension to Google Earth. And basically, this is going to be a way of actually pinpointing anybody at any time of the day for the future. So there you are. They're building this infrastructure. So it'd be just like all these prisons that have numbers on the doors. He's in cell six. Now you're in square, whatever it is. Pens remind rail. Anus Hogwarts drivel. Oh, sorry, I made that up. Huh? I wonder if this one. Look, anywhere you care to go. So where am I at the moment? I have no idea. I think it's by Oxford. It's got to be Oxford, hasn't it? Yes, it's got to be Oxford. Of course, of course. We could go to the Outer Hebrides. Let's go north a bit. You know this guy. Look, there's a square there. Look, you just randomly pick again. It's the square. Right. Shetland, they've got to have it. The Orkneys and the Shetlands. I mean, as if these people here are going to be navigating using squares on their island. And the Orkneys. And the Isle of Man? What about the Isle of Man? Come on, let's have a look at Isle of Man. Isle of Man? It's got to be, hasn't it? Yeah, because it's the Lancis is crossing the whole world. Oh, good heavens, the Isle of Man. Imagine living on there. Oh, good heavens, we have these squares now. We can get around. Yes, much easier than we ever did before. Imagine how efficient the TT race is going to be and the organisation therein. I don't know. So anyway, what can I say? Anglesey's probably got it. Yep. Oh yes, I was going to do, wasn't I? Yes, I did the north. Let's go to the south. Let's go just no go to south, isn't it? Right. Hey, well, there must be an Antarctic then, Antarctica, because yes, look, they've got squares as well. Yes, squares. What about this little bit there? Anyway, they've taken everything that's there and they've squared it. Put squares on. Yep. And I can't zoom out any more than that. That's as far as I can zoom out. But yes, there's whatever's down here they're hiding. I can't see it, but there's a square there. Mascarpone suppressors powerhouses, like right in this ditch in here. Look, now shall I? It's a bit pixelated, but it's going to. But those pixelations are going to have squares.
Oh look, sorry,
we have no imagery here. You don't have any imagery there because they don't want to show us. Sounds a bit conspiratorial, that, doesn't it? This looks conspiratorial to me. Ah, there we go. Squares. Squares. Yes. Today, people, we are looking at the square window. There we go. So, check it out, people. Have some fun. See what your square's called. Yes. Oh, come on. See, now I think there's a fault with this. Shall I help them and report this? Nah. All right. I could probably drag down. Can I? I can drag down. Maybe it'll sort itself out, will it? Come on, come on. No. And come out again. No. Okay. Maybe that's as far as I can go. So there we are. I shall leave it at that. So have fun with this. And again, it's called What-3-Words. And I'll put that as a subject title for this video. And I hope you enjoyed that. So I've been rambling on for long enough. Time for you to go and have a play yourself. So with that, thank you very much. And goodbye. Yes, goodbye.